Hallo, Namaste.
So once again we are here with another topic of Ayurveda.
Heute sind wir wieder mit einem Thema aus dem Ayurveda da.
Yeah, and today's theme is related with the Panch Bhautik Chikitsa in Ayurveda. It's a Panch Bhautik Chikitsa. It's a Sanskrit term, Panch Bhautik Chikitsa. This is the topic for today's talk.
Heute ist das Thema das, was er gerade genannt hat. Das ist ein Sanskrit-Wort.
Yeah.
Panchabhautik.
So Panchabhautik. When we say Panchabhautik, Panch means five. Bhautik means Bhautik, you know. Bhuta means like elements from which everything is formed. So it's related with the five elemental treatment theory in Ayurveda.
Es geht um die Fünf-Elemente-Therapie. Also Panchabhautik ist bezogen auf die Pancha, das sind die fünf, und Bhautik von den Bhutas, also von den Elementen.
No. So as there in Ayurveda, there are many principles, either the principle with the Tridosha theory, like where we do the treatment or the therapy with this Tridosha, you know, like with the Vata, Pitta, Kapha, or either where we do the therapy based on the Shodhana and Shamana, like Shodhana, like purification and Samana, that is the palliation therapy. So Panchabhautik therapy also it has its own basis.
Im Ayurveda haben wir verschiedene Konzepte. Wir haben die Konzepte von Tridosha, wo man eben die verschiedenen Doshas behandelt. Und es gibt auch die verschiedenen Konzepte von Shadana und Samana, also von der Reinigung und von der Ölung. Und die Fünf-Elemente-Therapie ist dann eben auch noch eine eigene Kategorie.
See, from the starting, the basic principle of Ayurveda is like a Yat Pinde Tat Brahmande, means like whatever in outside, that is in also in us. Means like it always connects individual with the universe, you know. So this concept is very deep when we look in very, very, very finely, when we observe, then we find that it's very deep concept. It starts from everything, you know, when you think everything. I will explain a little bit later.
Die Grundlage dieses Konzepts ist, dass alles, was uns umgibt, auch in uns zu finden ist. Also, dass wir in einem Zusammenhang mit unserer Umwelt stehen. Das ist die Grundlage dieser Fünf-Elemente-Therapie.
You know, for example, from how, what is the concept behind it? If a person is born in the month of March or April, you know, so during that time, when a person is born, so just by seeing a person's birth date, you can have the idea about a person's nature, what kind of nature that person would have later, and what kind of therapy, what kind of elements would be more helpful for that person.
Also alleine aufgrund des Geburtstages einer Person kann man schon eine Vermutung anstellen, was für eine Kondition, was für eine Konstitution die Person hat. Und Grundlage dessen, diese Eigenschaften, die dann vorherrschend sind, kann man dann auch der Therapie bezüglich ja schon prophezeien, was für Elemente eben besonders gut tun würden.
You know, just for example, if somebody is born in March, so what happens in the March? Normally, if you see March is a time, you can say it is a time between the winter and the spring, because spring is going to come by from April, mostly from April, not always sure, but yes, March is a winter time. And during winter time, what are the elements in outside? What is the mostly common element in the outside, in the in area, in the nature, generally in the March time period? So those children who born during that time period, in their body, those elements are in abundant. You know, they are the primary element in this, those kinds of children who born during the month of the March. What about the season there? What about the element in the outside season? Because if it is more cold and more like a more, you can say, moist is there, or also some part it can be more rainy, like as we see this year here. So whether it's more like it's a water, you know, water element more there, or whether you can say it's more like it's a more wind, so more the more luft. So that person's body, that the child who is born during that time period, his body has more water element and more luft element by birth. Okay, so yes.
Also Personen, die im Winter geboren sind, die zum Beispiel im März geboren sind, der eben zur Winterjahreszeit gehört, man würde dann eben schauen, welche Elemente besonders vorherrschend sind zu der Jahreszeit. Also im Monat März in diesem Fall würde es noch zum Wintermonat gehören, und da wären bestimmte Eigenschaften, die Vata erhöhend sind. Also Vata und so luftige Eigenschaften besonders besonders erhöht vorhanden und somit würde sich das auch auf die Konstitution der Person, die zu der Zeit geboren wird, würde sich das in dieser Konstitution zeigen. Das heißt, diese Person wäre dann vor allem Vata-dominant und hätte viel Luftelement.
You know, so it means that person's body naturally is it body has more, the child has more this Luft and water element. And but this is for Germany, you know, it's this reason, maybe this reason only in Bad-Meinberg. What about if somebody is born in Elgau during that month? What about if somebody is born in Africa? What about if somebody born in Asia? So when you see, it means that it changes to region to region. It changes to one continent to another continent. And this also changes to the time period of the year. Because in maybe in March, it is more like it's a Luft element and more like the water element. But when it comes to more summer time, then it will be the Luft, that is the air element, and more fire element. You see? So every person, based on different places, different times, different seasons, what will happen? As the in the outside nature, different elements are there. So those children, naturally, they will have those elements they are in abundance in their body. That is the first thing which we need to understand.
Also, Personen, die hier zu dieser Zeit geboren werden im März, die haben diese Konstitution, aber das kann sich von Ort zu Ort, von Region zu Region unterscheiden. Das heißt, die Aussagen kann man dann auch nur für eine spezifische Region treffen. Andere Kontinente, andere Länder haben dann auch andere Qualitäten, die zu der Zeit aktiv sind. Und wenn man dann eben schaut, welche Qualitäten sich zeigen, dann kann man die meistens auch in dem Körper des Kindes erkennen.
No. So for those kinds of people, when we know about a person who, okay, this person is born in maybe Bad-Meinberg, where during this month of March, it's more like it's a water and more air element more dominant. It means in the life span of that child who born here during this time period, he has to always careful of what? Number one is Luft and number second is water. You know, because too much Luft or water will always cause trouble to him or her, whatever it is. So water and Luft, air, these are the two elements which will cause more trouble. Or in future, if that person would suffer from any illnesses, there are more chances that he will get suffer either with the Luft or either with the water element.
Also Personen, die zu dieser Jahreszeit geboren werden, haben dann vor allem das Luft- und Wasserelement vorherrschend. Das heißt, die müssen dann meistens auch das ganze Leben darauf Rücksicht nehmen, diese Elemente in Balance zu halten.
You know, so his food, lifestyle, everything, whatever he do, he has to take care of according to this kind of seasons or this kind of elements, which were there the time of his birth or her birth.
Also die Elemente, die zur Zeit der Geburt besonders vorherrschend waren, die zeigen sich dann eben auch am stärksten in dem System und sollten auch am stärksten berücksichtigt werden.
You know, so for example, like if that person maybe in future if he get the sickness, then what kind of organs are more prone for that, that when that person will get sick? So those kind of structures, organs in the body which are more, you can say, dominant in those kinds of elements of the nature. What are those organs? For example, our lungs, which has more like mucus, so it's like water, and it has also more the area, the spaces, you know, like small alveoli, so more air, and we do a lot of things with the air in our lungs. So it means lungs are the reason or the structure in our body which are more related with the Luft and with the water element. So that person can have the trouble more with the Luft and the water element, which is the region, which one? System? The our lungs. So that person can have problem if his lifestyle is not balanced according to his the kind of elements he was born with, you know, or either with the constitution also. Most of times the constitution always goes together with this kind of elemental balance, you know. In some cases there can be exception, but mostly it goes with this balance, the kind of season he born, what kind of element outside. So his body type's constitution, most of times it goes with the balance out of it.
Also die Personen, die dann zum Beispiel das Wasserelement und das Luftelement besonders stark vorherrschend haben im System, sollten dann auch schon im Voraus darauf achten, bestimmte Krankheiten zu vermeiden, weil sie eine bestimmte Neigung haben, dann auch Krankheiten zu bekommen, die mit diesen Elementen zusammenhängen. Also für das Wasser- und Luftelement sind das dann vor allem eben die Atemwege und die Lungen, die dann sehr anfällig sein können, und da kann man dann besonders drauf achten. Ja. Meistens geht die körperliche Konstitution auch einher mit den Elementen, die sich zeigen.
Mm-hmm. And similarly, if a person who is born during the month of the summer time period, when I already said the summer is a time period where it's more like it's a fire, heat number one, so fire element, and the second is the Luft element. So it means that person will get, if his lifestyle is not so good, always lifestyle, food is number one in Ayurveda, you know. So if a person's lifestyle and the food stuff is not so good, then the kind of organ or structure which is more related with the fire element and the Luft element. So when we see in our body which structure more with the fire, that will come our stomach, you know, which is more nice. So stomach is number one, and then another one will come the liver. So that person can have the trouble more with this stomach and then with the liver. That is the second.
Personen, die eher später, also im Sommer geboren sind, die haben meistens vor allem das Feuerelement vorherrschend und auch noch etwas Luftelement. Und das, die dazugehörigen Organe sind dann vor allem der Magen und der Verdauungsbereich und die Leber. Und diese Personen können dann eben besonders darauf achten, diese Bereiche im Körper gut zu versorgen, dass die eben sich vor Krankheiten diesbezüglich schützen.
No. So in both the cases, when we think about based on this elemental, like what is the kind of elements with a child is born with, and what time we are going to give the treatment. So we always think about, okay, then what kind of herbs which are balancing for those kinds of element, you know. So if sometimes it's difficult for us to just find about, okay, what kind of disease it is and how to treat it, then we just treat the basic elements. This is the one principle of this panchabhautik therapy or panchabhautik chikitsa. Means like if we find out, okay, a child is born in the month of March, and during that time it was the water element and Luft element. So first thing I will just do is to balance the water element and this Luft element. So all the kreuters, all the herbs, or everything which is for the balancing of the water element and Luft element, this is what I have to do. This is very simple. So what we have to do for the water element, because water brings, then we have to check what are the qualities of the water, what it brings. Water is heavy, you know. Water brings the heaviness to the body. When someone has more water, what happens? The body becomes heavy, you know. And at the same time, water is also cold in nature. So coldness and heaviness, laziness. And what about the Luft? Luft is always, it brings more dryness. So dryness in the body, and on mental level, you can say water, air is also very, you can say, movement, vivegum, you know. So on the mental level also, it brings a lot of vivegum. It can be possible together with the water and the Luft element, because where water is more vivegum and it's very light, but this water, it has vivegum, but it is heavy.
Can I translate?
Yes.
Das Element Wasser und Luft sind Elemente, die eben dann therapiert werden durch Kräuter. Also wenn die Lebensführung stimmt, das ist die Nummer eins Priorität, die beachtet wird, wenn die Lebensführung, der Lifestyle stimmt, dann kann man eben mit ausgleichenden Kräutern therapieren. Das heißt, man nimmt die Kräuter, die die entgegengesetzten Eigenschaften haben, um die Eigenschaften dieser Elemente auszugleichen, so in Balance zu führen. Das heißt, Wasser hat eben die Eigenschaft, sehr kalt und schwer zu sein und aber auch flüssig zu sein, schleimig zu sein, und Luft hat eben die Eigenschaft, sehr luftig zu sein und beweglich zu sein. Also es bringt auch Unruhe in den Geist.
You know, so you need a kräuter which stops this kind of heaviness. You know, number one is because the water element is brings the heaviness and also coldness. So you need a balance of both that. So which brings light and same time which is also not heavy. You know, so what brings lightness? Those elements which are of the fiery in nature. Just for example, pepper. You know, pippali. So pippali or the ingwa, which are light in nature, like which brings lightness, and same time which are you can say which are highs in nature, because both Luft and the water, both of them, they are cold in nature. So something which is light and something which is fiery in nature, that is a treatment, basic treatment for that person. So if you don't know too much about a person, and based on the panchabhautik therapy, we will just prescribe that person, okay, you take more tea with ingwa and pepper, and you bring more of this ingwa and pepper in your food, like whatever you are cooking. Maybe because these people often suffer, like they eat anything, they even easily they can have bleungan, you know, they can, okay, they can't tolerate the beans, linsen or the kohl, they often have. So simply just changing a little bit things in their food, just adding this ingwa and pepper, it will do a lot of changes in their life.
Das heißt, das Wasserelement, welches von Natur aus vor allem die schwere und kühle Eigenschaft hat, die würde dann eben ausgeglichen werden durch ein Gewürz oder Kräuter, die von der Eigenschaft natürlich eher leicht und wärmend wirken. Das heißt, auch bei einer Person, die vor allem das Wasser- und Luftelement vorherrschend hat, die beide als Natur kühl sind oder auch kalt sind, würde man eben wärmende, leichte Gewürze empfehlen. Das kann zum Beispiel Pfeffer sein oder auch Ingwer. Das heißt, man kann dann für diese Person im Laufe der Zeit einfach in das Essen diese Gewürze hinzufügen und somit schon einen guten Effekt erzielen.
Ja. So this kind of principle not only here, but especially for the mental disorders also. Because what is mentioned in Ayurveda for the mental disorders, okay, for the guys, when we talk about the Gihon, like on the brain level, like this nervous system level, it is mainly regulated as per Ayurveda, that is the Vata dosha. And Vata dosha's main element is Luft element. So anything which has more Luft element, it will stimulate our brain tissue. You know, and this stimulation, when it is exaggerated, then there can be more trouble. So the elements which are related with more akasha, that is ether element, and with more luft element. So anything, either when we are traveling some places which is very dry in nature, because both akasha and like the luft, ether and the luft, both of them are dry in nature, both of them are rough in nature. So those dryness and roughness will also bring to our brain tissue. You know, and when it comes to our brain tissue, what happens when something is more dry and more rough, then it will start make degeneration.
Diese Behandlung bezieht sich auch auf die geistige Ebene. Das heißt, man kann auch auf der körperlichen Ebene ausgleichen, aber auch geistig die Eigenschaften der Elemente sehen und gegensätzliche Eigenschaften reinbringen. Das heißt, unser Nervensystem, unser Geist wird vor allem von dem Luftelement und von dem Ätherelement gesteuert. Und die haben die Eigenschaften, sehr leicht und auch rau zu sein. Somit würde man entgegengesetzte Eigenschaften reinbringen.
Yeah. So everything which is more like I say, which is either this kind of luft is and more like it's airy, you know, which brings this kind of dryness, they start actually degeneration on the tissue level. And which tissue level? Especially when we talk about in the brain tissue level, in Gehon level. So those people, then they start getting this kind of problem which generally happens. Either when the brain is getting dry, people cannot sleep properly. You know, when the brain tissue get more trocken, so sleep problems. And when someone cannot sleep properly, it means then from that, what can happen? Dementia, like forgetting. You know, so the memory, the gedächtnis, it became also dry. We say dry things. You eat more dry things, your brain become more dry. It doesn't mean that we should eat a lot of oily things. Balance. It's not like only eating dry. No. Dry, rough, no. You need always balance. That's why Ayurveda is a good like food, all which has all the six tastes, you know. So the principle is that it's not like that you should eat only dry. Only oily, because if you eat only dry, brain become dry. If you eat only oily, tissues, not only brain, but for the oily things, this gets more affected. So more oily things, your abdomen will get more affected with this oily thing.
Diese Trockenheit und Rauheit, die überträgt sich dann eben auch vor allem auf die Gewebe im Gehirn. Also das beeinträchtigt dann eben auch den Geist und die Vorgänge im Gehirn. Somit würde man wirklich aufpassen, dass man diese Eigenschaft minimiert, dass man nicht noch mehr Trockenheit und noch mehr Rauheit reinbringt. Je trockener das Gehirn, desto schlechter schlafen die Personen auch und das kann dann eben Demenz begünstigen. Gleichzeitig, so sehr man eben nicht versucht, noch mehr Trockenheit reinzubringen, würde man aber auch nicht zu viel Ölung reinbringen. Das würde sich dann meistens eher auf das Verdauungssystem auswirken.
So you need always to have a balance, and especially if something is coming, a kind of illness or a kind of sickness is coming from the dryness, the simple thing is just use some oil in your body, either eating, either doing in the form of massage, you know, like oiling massage, or either like when you are taking some food, adding some oil, which are especially good for the Luft, you know, to balance the Luft energy. So a Luft element, you can say, or which can also balance this this Raum, this ether, you know. So just like adding some kind of some little bit of linseed and oil regularly in your meal, it can help, you know. And also if you are taking any kräuter, so making that kräuter together with the oil or something which has more like fat, then it can go more in a deeper level of the brain, and it helps because the brain can assimilate or absorb it better when it is together with some kind of oil or some fat.
Das Effektivste gegen Trockenheit ist Ölung. Das kann von außen eben auch als Massage passieren, aber auch durch die Nahrung. Also Leinsamenöl zum Beispiel ist super gut oder auch Fett in Lebensmittelform. Das geht dann eben auch auf die Ölung alles, des ganzen Systems.
You know? So, and similarly, if somebody is like taking regularly more and more oil, you know, so naturally the oil are not cold. But they are of the opposite direction, you know. So generally oily substance, they are like a little bit heavier, you know. They are not hot, but they are heavy. So when they are heavy, it means then heavy things when we take, they mostly affect this kind of oily thing in our stomach, and they can bring the acid. So an acid is a little bit of fiery side. So even though oil are not directly fiery in nature, fiery element, but they can make this fire high. So if somebody takes more oily things, then what can happen? It can make a person to have a ulcer, or either this kind of gastritis, or either the more trouble with that of the liver, which is a fiery structure. So when we think about it, then we understand, okay, oil can make trouble with all the fiery structures in our body, and fiery structure either in our stomach or either our liver or either our gallbladder, you know. So to balance it, a person first of all stop taking oily thing, and second of all needs to bring some kind of food stuff which is not oily in nature, which is more dry in nature, but not excessively dry, but which is opposite to that of the oily in nature.
Also im Gegensatz dazu ist diese ölige Eigenschaft eher schwer, und man muss auf jeden Fall bedenken, dass Öl alle feurigen Strukturen im System nochmal verstärken kann, auch die Probleme damit verstärken kann, weil eben Öl, wie man sich das bei den Elementen auch so vorstellen kann, das Öl nochmal das Feuer weiter entfachen kann, und somit kann das zu einem Magengeschwür oder zu Gastritis, also auch Magenschleimhautentzündung und vor allem auch Leberproblemen führen, weil Leber ist auch ein feuriges System, eine feurige Struktur im System. Und somit würde man bei zu viel Öl auch eher wieder leichte Eigenschaften ins System reinbringen. Also nicht übermäßig trocken und übermäßig leicht, sondern moderat trockene Eigenschaften.
Mm-hmm. So this is also known as a concept in Ayurveda, we say about Dhatu Samya. So Dhatu means like our Gewebe, Dhatus are Gewebe, you know, the tissues. So all the tissues are also classified by based on their elemental constitution, you know. Each Dhatu, some Dhatu has more Ardha element, some Dhatu has more like fire element, some of the Dhatus they have more like water element, some Dhatus more like Luft element, or some Dhatus they have more Raum element or the Aether element. So what kind of food or lifestyle we can have, that kind of lifestyle or food can affect those Dhatus directly or indirectly, because the elemental constitution get affected, you know. And then when it get affected, then it can also create individual dhatu level disorders.
Also das Ayurveda beschreibt verschiedene Gewebe, die sieben Geweben, die Dhatus. Und die Dhatus, die setzen sich auch aus unterschiedlichen Elementen zusammen. Also verschiedene Gewebe haben eine unterschiedliche Zusammensetzung der Elemente. Und so kann man dann eben auch schauen, inwiefern die Lebensführung die verschiedenen Elemente und somit auch die verschiedenen Gewebe beeinflusst.
You know, for example, you see, just I take the bone element, like the Knochen. You see that, as I said, that phases is also limited, important, time is limited, and space is also limited. So we have to think in many phases. For example, in the cases of women, when they are in Vatsalyara, you know, when the woman go through a phase of Vatsalyara, so suddenly what happens in the Vatsalyara? Most of the cases, okay, some cases in the woman's cases, their body become more oily. But most of cases, the Vatsalyara is a phase of more dryness for the woman. So when I say dryness, means like the more vata, more luft, that is the phase of the more luft in your body, you know. So when there's a more luft, then what happens? There's a dryness in the joints, galank. When the dryness in the joint, then that is a time period where the woman, they can have start the symptoms of the arthritis. Number second, their bones, the Knochen, because Knochen are also made up of the luft dominant element. So the bone start losing the nutrition, because anything which is more dry, it will start degenerating. So the bone, which are like, there's a complete one bone, from inside the bone start getting porous. That is osteoporosis.
Gewebe, die Knochen, das Knochengewebe, das setzt sich vor allem aus dem Luftelement zusammen. Und am Beispiel von Frauen in der Menopause, da erlebt man oft, dass Frauen mehr Trockenheit und mehr dieses Luftelements im System bekommen. Bei einigen ist das auch so, dass die mehr öliges Element bekommen, aber bei den meisten ist das eher das luftige Element. Und so kann man dann auch erkennen, dass viele anfangen, Gelenkprobleme zu bekommen und da schon bestimmte Arthritis sich anfangen zu bilden. Und das aufgrund dieser Trockenheit des Luftelements, weil alles, was trocken wird, das degeneriert und verliert Nährstoffe.
You know, so that's why most of times for the woman's case, it is very helpful, like when they are approaching to their menopause, from then thereafter, they should regularly go for oil massage. Oil massage is very important for them, especially on the galang and the bones. You know, it is very important. If you don't find any special oil, just sesame oil, even though sesame oil is stroken, but you can make a mixture of sesame oil and mandel oil, which I generally recommend to many people, because if you can't have the ability to get all the Ayurvedic specialized oil, still you can make a simple oil which is a little bit more less trocken. The sesame oil can be trocken, so a mixture of the sesame and mandel oil is very simple but still quite effective. What you have to do to take this cold things away, just make it warm and then regularly applying on your joints daily, only 15 to 20 minutes of self massage. Especially during this, when this menopause time period is going to start in the woman's life, like around 45 years onwards. So 45 years onwards, they need to start self-massage regularly. And sometime going for the massage. It can help them a lot, especially for the joint. Otherwise, most of the women approaching 50, 55, they start having pain in their joints. And 60 onwards, it will be more prone. That they can have the more arthritic symptoms. It can happen throughout the body. That is natural, because this is the time period from 45 onwards, the dryness start increasing in the body of the woman. So that means the luft element start increasing more and more in their body. In men's body also it happens, but in comparison to female, men are more less prone. Female, they can have more dryness in their body.
Also besonders Frauen, die auf die Menopause zusteuern, also 45 aufwärts, sollten regelmäßig sich selbst einölen und auch gerne regelmäßig zur Ölmassage gehen. Und am besten ist es, wenn man vor allem die Gelenke einölt mit einer Mischung aus Sesamöl und Mandelöl. Das kann erhitzt werden, damit das eben auch das kalte Element verliert. Und dann eben mit dieser warmen Mischung aus diesen Sesam- und Mandelölen kann man dann eben regelmäßig, am besten täglich, die Gelenke und auch gerne den ganzen Körper einölen und regelmäßig zur Ölmassage gehen. Und das dann eben einfach so kontinuierlich weiterführen. Und besonders ab 60 führt das Risiko eben nochmal weiter in die Höhe, zu Trockenheit neigend. Und da dann eben besonders darauf achten. Männer haben meistens nicht so stark die Neigung zu dieser Trockenheit wie Frauen.
You know, so it means that during that time they should also take, because there are some things in our daily routine which can increase this looked element in our body also, you know. So like anything which is more dry, so like that is the time period you should not go any places which are more dry in nature, which is more windy in nature, and also people who like to awake up to midnight, that should be also avoided. So not only with these things, but about the eating the food, what kind of food you are a person is eating, whether you are eating more kind that kind of food which is more like it's a increasing the luft element in your body, and what kind of lifestyle, you know. So small things, very small things, but they can make a big difference.
Man sollte auch darauf achten, was für Nahrungsmittel man zu sich nimmt und auch auf was für eine Lebensführung man hat. Also man sollte dann eher Orte meiden oder auch Klima meiden, die besonders luftig sind, oder auch also Gewohnheiten wie spät in der Nacht noch aufbleiben vermeiden. Das sind alles Sachen, die das Luftelement fördern und somit dann eben auch nochmal diese ganzen Sachen verstärken. Und durch diese Kleinigkeiten wie Nahrungsmittel oder auch Lebensumstände können wir eben durch jede Kleinigkeit einen Einfluss darauf haben, wie sich etwas ausprägt, welches Element sich wie zeigt. Und so können wir eben durch viele Kleinigkeiten schon einen großen Effekt haben.
Okay, so I hope you understand some of the concept of the Panchbhautik therapy, which starts from the childhood, from the season, time, place, and different phases of the life, to also how to use the spices or how to use the different food stuff and how to use different kräuter for our well-being or to as a preventive measure also.
Und so sehen wir, dass diese ganzen Hilfsmittel, diese Lebensumstände, die wir beachten können, Gewürze, Lebensmittel und unsere Gewohnheiten, das sind alles ganz natürliche Hilfsmittel, mit denen wir einen großen Effekt haben können und in denen wir uns helfen können, auch schon prophylaktisch einfach helfen können.
Yes. So, do we have any questions in the chat?
Also gibt es irgendwelche Fragen im Chat oder auch im Raum?
Okay, so thank you very much for listening us patiently and thank you very much for joining here. And see you next time. Till then, namaste.
Vielen Dank euch fürs Zuhören und dann bis zum nächsten Mal. Namaste.